Fading kitten syndrome is a collection of symptoms that may result in a failure to thrive. There are many possible underlying causes, although in most cases, we will never know exactly what caused a kitten to fade. Fading kittens may present with the following symptoms: lethargy and weakness, dehydration, hypothermia, open mouth breathing or gasping, or crying out in pain. Acting quickly when you see these signs will increase the kitten's chance for survival. In this video, we will go over the steps you need to take in order to save a fading kitten. In the description, you will find links taking you to a correlating blog post with all of the steps listed, a complete supply list with product links, a guest blog post from the creator of the Parker Protocol, feeding charts, and contact information for assistance. The first thing you need to do is warm up the kitten. A towel or blanket may be used for this. You will swaddle him into a little burrito with only his face left uncovered. It's important to keep his head and ears covered. Keep him swaddled until he starts to fight the blanket. Next, you will place another layer of blanket or towel between the kitten and the heating pad to prevent burning or overheating. Set the heating pad on low. If you have a heartbeat kitty, you can place the heartbeat in the burrito. Even after the kitten is able to free himself from the swaddle, you will need to keep the heating pad under his blankets because young kittens can't regulate their own body temperature. This is the heating pad that I prefer because it doesn't have an auto-off feature. This heating pad will stay on until I turn it off and I don't have to worry about remembering to turn it back on every hour. Now that your kitten is warming up, it's time to raise his blood sugar. Give him an immediate dose of Karo syrup. If you don't have Karo, corn syrup, you can use real sugar dissolved into a thick paste, maple syrup, or something similar. Don't use something with an artificial sweetener as this will not raise blood sugar levels. You can give the kitten 0.1 milliliter of Karo in a dosing syringe, or you can scoop a bit of syrup onto your finger and wipe it into the kitten's mouth. Leave the kitten swaddled while you prepare the rest of your supplies. If you are able to administer subcutaneous fluids, you will need to prepare your lactate and ringers now. The kitten will need about 10 milliliters of fluids per 1 pound of the kitten's weight. So if your kitten weighs half a pound, you will give him 5 milliliters. Draw the fluids into the syringe and set them aside to warm up. I use a coffee cup of hot water and set the syringe inside for a minute. While the fluids are warming, you will prepare the Karo electrolyte solution. Start with half a cup of electrolytes and mix in 3 tablespoons of Karo syrup. If you are able to administer the sub-Q fluids, do so now and re-swaddle the kitten. Gather up all of your supplies and get comfortable with your kitten. I like to set the kitten up in a small box so that I have a safe place to set him down if needed. It also makes him mobile. Just unplug his heating pad and plug it back in after you move. This tip is helpful as you could be working the protocol for several hours and it's likely that you'll need to move around during this time. Fill your 1 milliliter dosing syringe with the Karo electrolyte solution and prepare your timer for 3 minutes. The kitten must be held in an upright position for feeding and dosing. A kitten cannot be held on his back like a human baby or he could choke on the liquid. Position the tip of the syringe into the side of his mouth and slowly push 0.1 milliliter of the solution so that it drips into the mouth. Start your timer. You will repeat this step every 3 minutes. Don't be discouraged if your kitten does not respond right away, as it can take several hours before you see results. When your kitten is conscious and no longer limp, you may move on to the next step. The instructions in the protocol use a 1 milliliter dosing syringe. You will be starting with 0.1 milliliter, which is a very small amount. Be careful not to mistake the 0.1 doses for 1 whole milliliter. This is what 0.1 milliliters looks like in a 1 milliliter syringe. Once your kitten is conscious, you will introduce a formula electrolyte mixture. You will alternate this with the Karo electrolyte mixture and slowly increase the doses and time intervals. There are detailed charts to help you with the final steps in the protocol. You will find the complete Parker protocol linked in the description. You continue working the protocol until your kitten is back to normal. Carolyn Bishop, the creator of the Parker protocol, has agreed to do a guest blog post for us. You can find Carolyn's full blog post linked in the description. She focuses much of her attention on the harder cases such as kittens that are failing to thrive and kittens with medical issues. She has a ton of experience in saving fading kittens and has been kind enough to offer support if more help is needed beyond these resources. Let's go over a few more things. The heartbeat kitty is a stuffed animal with a removable heartbeat. The heartbeat is incredibly soothing and comforting to tiny kittens that don't have a mama cat to care for them. You can remove the heartbeat and tuck it into their bedding, or leave it in the Velcro pouch of the mama. The pouch will also hold hot packs to radiate warmth from the stuffed animal. The heartbeat mama kitty is not necessary, but it is extremely helpful to have on hand. I highly recommend investing in one if you foster often. To determine if your kitten is dehydrated, you'll pinch the skin above their shoulder blades at the scruff of their neck. If the kitten is dehydrated, the skin will stay pinched up or tented. The skin on a hydrated kitten will immediately snap back into place after it's released. You have a couple options when you choose your electrolytes. You can buy unflavored Pedialyte or a generic brand in a ready-to-use liquid, or you can use packets of powder. The Mommy's Bliss electrolytes in powder form can be mixed up in small batches so that you don't have to open up a whole bottle of Pedialyte. Pedialyte is supposed to be tossed after 24 hours, so it can be a bit wasteful when you're only using a small amount for a little kitten. I highly recommend investing in a miracle nipple, especially if you foster often. They are different than the regular nipples that you will find with a nursing bottle set. They come with a pre-made hole that provides the perfect flow, which helps reduce the chance of aspiration. All of my kittens have nursed so much better with the miracle nipple. They come in two sizes, mini and regular. So far, all of my kittens have preferred the mini. This isn't everything you'll ever need to know about caring for fading kittens, but it should get you off to a good start. If you have any questions after checking out the protocol, the blog posts, and the other resources I'm providing, you are welcome to contact me or Carolyn for more help. Our contact information will be in the description.